As-siyam is a means for thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and also it is a way to tame ourselves. Taming ourselves is when I want to eat, I eat. When I want to drink, I drink. Whatever I want, I do it. In the month of Ramadan, 16, 17 hours a day of fasting, we are humans. Sometimes we want to eat. We are hungry or thirsty. And some people are addicted to coffee and tea and other things. So when they come during the day and they want to do this, but they cannot do it because they are fasting, then we are controlling our desires and our needs, and we are taming ourselves, and we are putting ourselves down. Why? Because we are seeking the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we are asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgiveness. And another way of the siyam also makes the heart busy with remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when we fast, the heart will not be as the way we are eating and drinking. If you ask the physicians and those people, the scientists who study the human body, they will tell you that food and drink, when you eat too much, first you can get any disease, you can be sick, and also it helps your desires to develop and to be more and more, and you want more and more. When you put down food and drink, it puts down your desires. When the desires go down, when the food and drink is cut from the human body and we take some breaks from the food and drink, then our heart will come to work. And when the heart comes to work, it works usually as a normal human. We think about our actions and doing some kind of ibadah, but not the same way when we are fasting. So siyam will make the heart just focused on dhikrullah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to think about the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the siyam will take us out of the heedless state that we stay in for 11 months. It's heedless because we don't see what other people are facing. We don't go to these places in Africa and other places where people cannot find something to eat. They don't have any shelter. They don't have any home. They stay days and days with no food. And when they come to drink, they drink some dirty water. So this will make us think about these situations. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when we are in this situation, we will appreciate what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given to us. And also, after this, we will have some thinking about the heedless state that we are in, and we will go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And siyam also will teach us a lesson, especially those who are well off, those Muslims who are okay, who have money and they can eat and they have whatever they want, they get. Siyam will let those people thinking of the poor. The poor who is maybe my neighbor, your neighbor, that sometimes we eat, drink, every day we have a different meal, we cook in the house and we go out for restaurants and all these things, and sometimes we never think about our neighbors. And it doesn't matter if the neighbor is Muslim or non-Muslim. Because if your neighbor is a Muslim or a non-Muslim, you should be kind and generous to them. Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also says in the hadith that you will not be a Muslim if you are full and your neighbor is hungry. If your neighbor sleeps a night and he or she is hungry, they don't have access to food, and you are eating and you have extra, and sometimes we put the food in garbage, unfortunately, and some people need the food, this is not a mu'min. We have to look after our neighbors. We have to see, we know the situations of each other. We know if he or she has a job or not. If he or she is having access to some fund or not. So if we know the real situation and we do not help, then we will not be among the mu'mins. And Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will not be happy with us. If they are Muslims and non-Muslims, we have to feed them, we have to help them. And Siyam also will put down our prideness and our arrogance. Sometimes we are having this dignity of humanity. We want to be better than everyone. When we talk to the people, sometimes we talk from a point that we look at them down. I am here and you are here. When you fast, Siyam will take this arrogance and pride down. And also Siyam will get rahmah, mercy, to be planted in your heart. And once rahmah comes into the heart, all other negative thoughts and qualities will get out of the heart. And also a Siyam, it combines all three categories of sabr, patience. That's why Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam called Shahr Ramadan the Shahr of patience, the month of patience. Because patience, as ulama explained, they said patience generally is three categories. First, patience for ibadah, to pray every day five salah and sunan, and to be obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and not to do anything bad. This needs patience. The second category is patience to stay away from disobedience. You live in a community where there is an access for each and every evil thing. You can do it. No one is gonna watch you. You can do whatever you want, but you are not doing it because you are afraid of the punishment of Allah. You are a Muslim. So this is kind of sabr, patience for ma'asiyah. You don't go for ma'asiyah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the last one is patience for the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whatever comes is good for us. Even if it looks bad or evil, it is good for us. So these three categories are in the fasting. When we fast, we are obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When we fast, we are away from disobedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When we fast, we are accepting the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whatever comes from Him subhanahu wa ta'ala, we accept. And also, sawm or fasting, if you ask physicians and scientists too, they will tell you that siyam will help your body to get rid of all the poisons that come from the food and stay in our stomach for maybe weeks or months. And if we don't fast, we may get sick. But when we stop eating for a long time, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He refreshes our soul, our mind, our heart, as well as our body. Our body gets rid of all the bad things in the stomach, and then the blood is coming to another cycle, and we get revival in each and everything in our body. So it is healthy physically and spiritually for us. And Siyam is a kind of ibadah that gives me a new sign that this person is a real believer in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All of us can come for salah. All of us sometimes can give some sadaqah. But to fast regularly during the year, Mondays, Thursdays, 13, 14, 15, and all the voluntary fasting, and when Ramadan comes, and before Ramadan in Sha'ban, this tells you that this person is a special person. Because not each and every Muslim continues the fast after Ramadan. So it is a sign that this person, you can take him or her as a friend, because if he or she is doing this, means that he or she has taqwa Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And anyone who has taqwa Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you shouldn't be afraid of accompanying him or her. Because if he's afraid of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is never gonna harm you. But those who just live their lives with no control, with no limits, they do whatever they want, sometimes you will be cautious. Because if they don't follow Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they may be a reason to harm you or to affect you negatively. So Siyam is a sign for us to know that this person is close from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then if we move to the month of Ramadan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala first preferred the month of Ramadan because It is the month that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the Quran to Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When he subhanahu wa ta'ala says, شَهْرُ رَمَضَانَ الَّذِي أُنزِلَ فِيهِ الْقُرْآنُ هُدًى لِلنَّاسِ وَبَيِّنَاتٍ مِّنَ الْهُدَى وَالْفُرْقَانِ. That month of Ramadan is the month during which the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam got the Quran from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also, the ulama told us that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also told us that all the books that came from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to other prophets and messengers, it came during the month of Ramadan. So it is not just Quran that came from Allah to Sayyidina Muhammad in Ramadan. It is the sheets of Ibrahim alayhi salam that came to Ibrahim alayhi salam in the first day of Ramadan. And it is Torah that came to Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam in the sixth day of Ramadan. And it is the Injil that came to Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam in the 11th day of Ramadan. And it is the Quran that came to Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Laylatul Qadr in Ramadan. So Ramadan is a special month because all the major scriptures came from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala during that month to the prophets and the messengers. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about Laylatul Qadr in Surah Al-Qadr that we know, Inna anzalnahu fi Laylatul Qadr. We have revealed the Quran during the night of Qadr. Qadr means a status. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will raise your status, we will say He will raise your Qadr. And it's called Laylatul Qadr, the night of decree, the night of power. That night that has a special status, it is the best night during the year because of the Quran that came from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then the month of Ramadan is more specialized with opening the doors of Jannah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opened the doors of Jannah, closes the doors of the fire, chains the shayateen and the rebels from jinn, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opens the doors of the heavens, the doors of Rahmah are open, and also there is a caller will call when Ramadan comes. Ya baghi al-khayri aqbil, O seekers of goodness, come forward. Wa ya baghi al-shari aqsir, O seekers of evil, go back, stop. So those people who are evil, they have no place in Ramadan. They have no time in Ramadan. Those seekers of goodness, those believers, they have all the time in Ramadan, and the environment was prepared by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for them to do more a'mal to be rewarded by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as we know, the first night of Ramadan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives the Muslims, and also each and every night Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgiveness will come down on the Muslims. The month of Ramadan, it is so special because, as we said, Laylatul Qadr, the night of Al-Qadr, and Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us that month has one night that if you are prevented from the goodness during that night, you are really prevented from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rahmah, which is Laylatul Qadr. So we have to count for Laylatul Qadr once Ramadan starts, and when the 10 nights of Ramadan, last night start, we should be very cautious, and we should spend most of the night in ta'a, salah, qira'atul Quran, doing something good, azkar, not to miss Laylatul Qadr. And also, Shahr Ramadan is a time that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts the dua. And He subhanahu wa ta'ala frees many people from the fire of hell that it was written for them during the month of Ramadan. And it is the month of dhikr and shukr, being thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and being a Muslim who is always remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When He says, وَلَتُكَبِّرُ اللَّهَ عَلَى مَا هَدَاكُمْ وَلَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ, you say Allahu Akbar, you make takbir to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for what He has guided you subhanahu wa ta'ala, that you may be among the thankful ones. Shahr Ramadan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives the sins when He says, Man sama Ramadana imanan wa ihtisaban ghufra lahu ma taqaddama min dhanbih. If you fast the month of Ramadan, your previous sins are forgiven. And also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us this, and Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam explains another hadith when he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was going to the minbar to give the khutbah, and he stopped for three times and he said, Ameen, Ameen, Ameen. And then he explains to the Sahaba, radwanullahi alayhim, after Salatul Jum'ah, and he said, Jibreel came to me and he said, miserable is him, the one that Ramadan comes and goes without him being forgiven. Muhammad say Ameen, Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said Ameen. And another one, miserable is him, the one that your name Muhammad is mentioned and he doesn't say sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say Ameen. Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said Ameen. And Jibreel alayhi salam said, miserable is him, the one that he lives with his parents, both of them or one of them, and they do not take him to Jannah, say Ameen. Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said Ameen. And this is an indication that Ramadan is a special month for forgiveness. And we have to prepare for this and we have to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgiveness when Ramadan comes. Another way of Ramadan, it is a month that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala elevates the ranks of the believers. So when we fast during the day, when we make the adhkar, when we read the Quran, we are actually opening a bank account with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the first day of Ramadan, and each and every night in Ramadan, our account gets more and more and more, and we save more and more each and every night with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. By the end of the month, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grants us the big stamp of forgiveness and rahmah and acceptance, and this is the reward that he subhanahu wa ta'ala is given. And also the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was asked one day about two sahaba ridwanullahi alayhim who passed away, who died. And Sayyidina Talha ibn Ubaydillah, one of the Mubashareen bil Jannah, one of the Sahaba who was given the glad tidings of Jannah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as we know, Ashra Mubashareen, the 10 Sahaba were given the news of Jannah, they are going to Jannah when they are alive. Talha ibn Ubaydillah is one of them. Sayyidina Talha came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he said, I have seen in my vision that I am waiting at the doors of Jannah. And these two brothers who passed away are cold. The first one who enters, one of them died in front line, in jihad. And as we know, jihad is the peak of Islam. The best deed that you can do is jihad, to fight in the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to die in the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And another person died a normal death. They are both Sahaba. And the Sayyidina Talha says that I see the person who died normally going to Jannah before the person who died in the war, fighting for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cause. And then the other person is called later to Jannah. So Sayyidina Talha ibn Ubaydillah, when he wakes up from that dream, he starts talking to the people. And then they go to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is saying, why are you shocked? They say, because the one who's going to Jannah next or second, he was the one who died in front line. And the one who went first is the one who died a normal death. Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the second person who died, the one who went to Jannah first in the dream, he said, didn't he live one more year after the other one died? He said, yes. They said, yeah, he died 1 year later. Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked, didn't he witness the month of Ramadan? They said, yes, he witnessed. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, didn't he fast and pray and do sujood and sunan in the month of Ramadan? They said, yes, he did. Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says in the hadith, فَمَا بَيْنَهُمَا أَبْعَدُ مِمَّا بَيْنَ السَّمَاءِ وَالْأَرْضِ. The month of Ramadan that the other person lived for the next year and he did some good actions made him go to Jannah before the one who died in the front line in jihad. So this gives us an idea how big is Ramadan with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and how big is the reward that the fasting people can go in Jannah before the martyrs. before the shuhada. So that's why when we make dua, we say, oh Allah, please give us long life and good amal. Those who live long and do good, they will be definitely better in a'mal than these Muslims who lived short. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will enable them to do good, and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward them. And also, if you want to get more from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then you perform a umrah.